Take a look around your property. What may look like pleasant greenery could be an invasive plant that wants to spread, and spread fast until it's choked out the natural, beneficial plants that should make up your forest floor. As you'll see, there are many different invasive plants in Wisconsin, but they all have one thing in common. They are here to take over.
We do use a phrase at the Leopold Foundation that we call cut it, spray it, burn it. And literally that's the three things you have to do, not in that order, not always in that order, and sometimes you don't need all three, but you have to cut it, spray it, and burn it if you want to regenerate oak.
The Japanese barberry, it's another invasive. It's a small shrub with little thorns on it. What happens with that is if in the right soils, it can take off and just displace everything else. And same thing with the honeysuckle. It overshadows everything, doesn't let anything else germinate. And then of course the buckthorn can actually change the soil pH, which makes it very difficult for other more native species, desirable trees, to actually germinate and survive.
They came here basically on our boots and on the tracks of our tires. So it's incumbent upon us, it's our responsibility to try to take care of them, to control them, so the native vegetation has a chance to grow.
What's interesting about these invasive plants is that some of them were brought here on purpose and thought to have beneficial uses.
50 years ago, someone in my shoes might have told you to plant some of these plants. Autumn olive, we thought, was a great wildlife shrub because it produces berries and it can fix nitrogen. Multiflora rose, we thought, would be a good living fence. Garlic mustard was brought in as a salad green from our European ancestors. So the intent was positive. But unfortunately, when we make a change to the environment, we don't always know what the repercussions are going to be.
It sounds daunting, doesn't it? Well, it doesn't have to be. Whether you have an acre or 100 acres, the steps you can take to eliminate invasive species are easy to implement. But it takes persistence and determination to conquer these space invaders.
In this part of Wisconsin, south of the tension zone, a lot of these places were former oak savanna or prairie ecosystems. Seeds can remain viable in the seed bank on that forest floor for up to 100 years. There's some evidence of even longer. We can, by mowing, get that sunlight back down there and hopefully get some of those native prairie plants and native oak savanna plants and to germinate again and come back up.
So seed banks are kind of like buried treasure in your soil. They're already there. They're just waiting for you to get rid of these invaders and take back the sunlight the seed banks need to grow back. All you need to do is get outside and get going. Contact your local DNR forester. They'll help you learn how to identify any exotic species you may have on your land and point you toward the tools you'll need to control them. In our next segment, we're gonna get a little wild. Wildlife, that is. The forest is home to so much wildlife, and if you're a hunter, gatherer, or maybe a bird watcher, there are lots of ways you can improve your woods and make it perfect habitat for four-legged creatures and birds alike to go wild in your woods.